See if we can zoom in on that.
But it's sharks were only the beginning, you know, and as you can see, this costume takes it one step further. Anybody could have a shark. I went further. Sharks were only the beginning. What you have is killer pigfish.
We are about to experience the launching of pigfish. Now, what is the goal here, Richard?
Our goal is to reach the rooftop of this building down here, Michael. And given the fact that the pigfish is not really an aerodynamic animal, I don't know if we can get far enough out to reach the roof. Say goodbye, Mr. Pigfish.
To fly like an eagle to the sea.
He has landed. The big fish has landed.
Successful mission.
Michael, I'd like you to notice what a shot. I mean, we're talking the very center of the roof.
Was not even close to the edge there.
The big fish really flew well.
Yes, he did.
I'm very surprised.
Was that how aerodynamically sound was that pigfish?
I think, Michael, was the pigfish's fin caught in the air and glided, causing a gliding effect, carrying it about another 30 yards, enabling it to reach the top of the roof.
Okay, now projection. How long would that pigfish stay on that roof?
I'm willing to bet it's going to be about 3 weeks.
Okay, you understand that every morning
we will do a pigfish.
We'll do a little pigfish update and see if it's still there. So
what I'm hoping is it'll get some rain, it'll start molding, start smelling, animals will start coming to it, and we'll have a lot of entertainment on that rooftop.
I understand. All right.
Notice the day and time. A good week after the catapult, pigfish still resides on the neighboring roof. November 12th, 808. We're going to the window. We're going to see if pigfish still exists. And it does. Laying out there, sunbathing, acting like a good pig. November 13th. We're at the window. Moment of truth. Oh boy. Right. Yes. Big fish.
Let's look down to the rooftop where pigfish lives.
Pigfish
has
moved.
That is
very
interesting.
Pigfish has moved! Now, how has pigfish moved?
He's trying to get to the edge. He's trying to escape.
Is it an animal that has moved pigfish, or a human, or has pigfish moved himself?
Well, that is bizarre.
Mm-hmm.
That is really bizarre.
I'm baffled.
We're going to have to keep up to date on this. Richard, we have important news here. We have something important happening here.
We do.
Point it out.
Pigfish. Gone.
Oh, God.
Gone. One morning after we saw the pigfish.
It went for the side.
Now,
where is it?
I don't know, Michael. We had a little stormy weather last night. We had some wind. I'm wondering if pigfish is off to the right side of the building. Michael, I think a search and rescue mission may be in order.
Looking down for pigfish. We don't see pigfish.
Vantage point. Okay, that's the roof for where pigfish was. Absolutely no sign of him. Richard, what's the next step?
Onward. We should drive to the possible pigfish landing spot, and we'll do a little searching.
If we do indeed find him, is there medical attention available?
We'll rush him to First Presbyterian over here Hospital. They have a special pigfish center. Best we can do.
All right.
What are we doing?
We're searching for pigfish. We're actually going to drive into the driveway and do a search and recovery mission. And if we find him, we're going to rush him off to the hospital and try to save him, or we may relaunch him. What's that mean, Richard?
That driveway is where we need to get to try and find pigfish.
But he's no longer in there.
We can't get through.
What we got, Richard?
We have a pigfish sighting.
No.
Come.
We're just trying to get that doll right there in the driveway. Of the pig, see the little pig doll thing? So you can watch us if you'd like. We should grab and leave. There it is.
Oh my God.
There it is.
You're right.
Big fish!
Let's run to it.
Oh my God.
It's been through a beating.
Fish looks battered and tattered.
What do we do now?
We launch it.
We have picked fish too.
A battered,
the relaunch,
and torn pigfish shall now have his head.
We are going into surgery here.
A very precise incision is made.
Now, Richard, what are we doing here?
Well, we're adding weight. I think we might have too much, but
fitting in there. We have pennies are in. One last long look at pigfish.
Michael, describe what we have done, as I'll follow you. Go ahead. What we have done to the pigfish, explain to our audience what we're about to.
We have made pigfish more aerodynamically sound now. Through the small insertion in the back of the head, we have added sufficient weight to give it proper projectile status. Okay? And as such, when it lands on the roof, it should stay there. It will limit its ability to move around and try to go for the edge and jump off like it did before. Pigfish is ready for flight.
Let's do it.
We are walking to the launch site. Richard, I remember being here just 2 weeks prior in this same sort of scenario.
We've got quite a wind up here, concerns me. But I think the weight that we've added to pigfish will overcome that wind.
Now, do you think you will be able to hit the center of the roof as you did before?
I'll certainly try. I think we'll hear it hit this time.
I want to get away. I want to fly away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I want to get away. I want to fly away. Yeah.
That was a good toss. Not quite in the center.
No.
But
I think the wind must have blown it. It couldn't have been my throwing ability.
But it's firmly on that roof, and you hit a nice center portion as well.
What I like is pigfish is kind of looking towards us from our apartment.
You're right. Well, let's take another close hand look at that face. It's awesome. Richard, the added weight to pigfish. Talk to me about it.
Well, Michael, I didn't throw it quite as hard as last time because of the weight. And I think the weight's going to keep that pigfish on the roof until an animal or a human removes him.
San Francisco. Beautiful. Warm. Luxurious. But even this beautiful scenery is marred by one thing. Yes, a pigfish resting in all its ugliness on a neighboring rooftop in Pacific Heights.
December 14th, morning.
Richard's having a little breakfast. It's been a long time since we did a pigfish update. Let's take a little glance. Yes? Still there?
Resting comfortably.
I'm parched. Pigfish. At night.
Is he down there?
There he is.
Oh,
he's wet.
He is beautiful down
he's
there.
He's wet and he's cold and he's pissed.
No. Well, that's good though. He's still there.
You know why he's angry?
Why?
He has no Christmas tree.
Now, Richard, please tell us what we have here.
Michael, in the spirit of giving, we have a pigfish Christmas tree.
Very nice.
It is a lovely tree. And we have a little gift for Mr. Pigfish. You can zoom in on that.
Let's take a glance at this.
Mr. Pigfish, Merry Christmas.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars.
Well, it's close.
Well, I wish it was closer to Mr. Pigfish, but
well, he's going to have
to. On the roof.
He's going to have to look at it from a distance.
I don't know how this is going to fly with this shade. We'll see.
You were born. You were born, yeah. You were born to fly.
Oh, it's sailing. Come back.
It's even further away.
It got a planing effect. It went sideways.
I think it's time for us to be able to say, though, Merry Christmas to Mr. Pigfish and a Happy New Year.
Yes. We did our best.
I think he'll be proud. Wave to him, Richard.
I'm not going to wave to him. Let's go.
Looking at a wet pigfish. Wet Christmas tree. As well as a little wet gift.
I'm a little nervous, Richard. First, this is a very good bottle of champagne that we're going to be giving.
Fine.
And I'm a little worried that once I throw this thing, it's going to produce a large hole at the top of that roof.
It's a little heavier than you realize, isn't
heavier.
It?
And I'm very concerned that if I happen to hit Mr. Pigfish with it, it might cause some hemorrhaging and we might lose him for good. I'd like to wish Mr. Pigfish a Happy New Year. Welcome to 1992, Mr. Pigfish.
A direct hit, nicely centered. It did, however, disturb some pigeons. Pigfish is thrilled.
The beginning of a new day. The beginning of a new year. For Mr. Pigfish. And there he is. still resting on the roof, with his tree nearby, his present nearby, and of course, his little bottle of champagne.
Michael?
Richard?
I feel as if a good friend has died.
You're looking distressed. What's happened?
Moments ago, I looked out the window for our morning check of Mr. Big Fish. He was gone.
Let's take a look.
Pick a slat, any slat.
That roof's looking very clean there. No longer is... He's not there. His little champagne bottle's not there.
His tree is gone.
And his present has also disappeared.
Notice his little friends, the birds, are gone as well. The little live birds that used to play with him every day.
How long was he on that roof, Richard?
Since Halloween, Michael.
So we're talking 3 months. It's the morning after. Reality sets in. Pigfish no longer on the roof. When will funeral services be held, Richard?
I really can't talk about it right now. I have to be alone.
The Lord is my pig farmer. Therefore can I lack nothing. He shall feed me on a rooftop and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort. He shall convert my soul and bring me forth into the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I shall fear no evil or rooftop cleaners. For thee art with me, thy rod and thy staff, and thy Christmas tree, Christmas present, and little champagne bottle. Comfort me. Thou shalt prepare a table before me in the presence of them that trouble me or throw me away. Thou hast anointed my head with oil and inserted pennies. My cup runneth full. Surely thy loving kindness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my pigfish life, and I will dwell on the rooftop of the Lord forever.
Flowers for pigfish.
Ready, Michael?
Yep.
Two pigfish. One, two, three.
We're done.
It's nearing Christmas. Richard, what do you think? It's nearing Christmas, is it not?
It is. Let's look.
Let's take a look.
The season is upon us, and Pigfish...
Let's wish Mr. Pigfish a Merry Christmas.
He's ready to celebrate.
Is he there? Oh, yes, he is. I love Mr. Pigfish. Look at him out there.
Oh, with his birdie friends.
Oh, look at that. You're right. He's got some friends out there. You know what? Mr. Pigfish is quite beautiful.
really resting.
All I know is that if Pigfish were alive, he still couldn't find a place to eat at 10 o'clock at night in the city. You know, so if Pigfish were in New York, I might have some sympathy, but we're all in it together here in San Francisco. Now, bye, Pigfish. I love you.
All right, Melanie says, here's to you, Pigfish.
We're looking at a very depressed Pigfish, former Pigfish friend.
Can we talk about what happened to Pigfish?
I love Pigfish. And he's gone.
I never really knew Pigfish. I mean, I heard a lot about him, but I never met him personally or anything.
No.
And, God, I would really like to have known him.
It's sad.
I heard, you know, about Halloween and Christmas time and New Year's. I mean, you know, I was really sad, and I had seen him from afar, you know, a bunch of times I'd seen him.
It's been a shock. The week has been a very difficult one, Michael. To wake up and know that he's not there on the road.
He's not there.
At our
it's
apartment.
Gone.
The presents aren't there.
It's a security blanket type
That's
thing.
That's right. It is a security thing to know that he was there looking after us, and he's gone. And he's gone forever. He's not coming back.
Where do you think he
and
is,
I can't
right
accept that. He's not returning to us.
Where do you think he is?
I think he's in a trash can.
Oh, God.
No, we're
going to the dump.
Lonely, upset, pissed off in a trash can.